Male.
Well, definitely. They were like 3-2 or 3-1, and they've lost 3 in a row. And now things look bleak for Adamson because of the absence of Ramil Tagupa. While in today's ball game for DLSU, they've won their last 2 games. While itong UAAP Red Warriors, nobody gave them a chance to even win 1 game in this season. So now, Coach Tinto Pumarin is really doing a heck of a job for his team. And right now, he's aiming for his 4th victory.
The front court will be a problem for UAE. LaSalle has beefed up over the last 2 or 3 years in terms of size in the head-to-head matchup. As you take a look at some of the numbers, the rebounding is something we will keep a close watch on.
That's correct. Of course, itong LaSalle, the number 6 team as far as rebounding is concerned, while the UAAP Red Warriors, because of their small lineup, they're the last place team in the rebounding area, only 37.5 rebounds per ball game. Take a look at the points per game or the offense and the defense, halos pare-pareho lang yan, even the field goal shooting, so wala masyado may advantage dyan. While for in the turnover department, De La Salle University, you talked about how they beefed up sa kanilang backcourt. They're the team na yung kanilang pag-handle na bola, eh talagang ingat na ingat sila. As a result, they're the number 1 team as far as controlling the ball and limiting their turnovers is concerned.
Last time around, the De La Salle Green Archers had a bit of a problem against the University of the Philippines Fighting Maroons, falling behind by as much as 15 points. But the ninja suddenly got his cue, his call, he was out firing and scoring, he was hot in that particular game. He was the reason why LaSalle was able to come back.
That's right. In the first 5 games for Joseph Yeo, he only averaged 9.4 points per ball game and only 34.5% from the field. While against UP, he erupted for 23 and scored 9 in the pivotal 4th quarter. And that was a key victory for LaSalle. Hindi sila pwedeng matalo ron sa UP, and now they have a very good momentum against UAAP Red Warriors today.
Okay. The UAE Red Warriors, on the other hand, are not without their own firepower, so to speak. Paolo Hubaldi has been playing well of late. Casey Canaleta likes us. We ask him to do a dunk. He does a dunk for the panel, and we expect more of that today. They will need it against De La Salle.
That's right. In the games, how important is Paolo Mendoza, Paolo Hubaldi rather, for this team? 17.7 points per game in the games that they've won, and only 8.3 points in the games that they've lost. And even the field goal shooting is pretty low for Paolo Hubaldi every time they lose. So talagang he's really the chief warrior, is really counted upon as far as scoring is concerned. He's the number one scorer para rito kay Coach Tinto Pumarin.
A lot of people are panicking when KG Canaleta decides to take a 3-point shot because he's such a big man. But I think that's part of his package. He's trying to add that to his arsenal.
That's right. Everybody knows that he can score. He can score on the fast break. He can score on layups. Kaya ngayon, medyo dinagdagan niya yung kanyang arsenal. But what is nice about KG, he finally took over in the last 2 games. Only 7.3 points per game in the first four games of UE. But he has erupted for 20.5. And look at the field goal shooting. So lahat yon, his game is getting better every game. Yun ang napaka-importante dahil ito ang dalawang players na to na talagang kinakailangan ng UE para makapasok dun sa next level.
And it's going to be a great one, Coach Ryan Gregorio. This is a hot one between the Pumarin brothers. Basketball has been their life, their passion. They played against each other. We've managed to cover them. In that regard, we'll cover them in a different light here today as UE takes on De La Salle.
UAAP band live here at the Big Dome. It's the Canaleta Coliseum. It's Saturday Blockbuster. Welcome to the main event. It's the La Salle Green Archers versus the UE Red Warriors. Definitely a good game coming up. Let's see our best-of-bang starting 5. Starting for the La Salle Green Archers. At guard, number 11, standing 5'7", T.Y. Zed. And the other guard, number 18, standing 6'1", Ryan Araya. Center, number 15, standing 6'5", Mark Bedney. Buenaventura, Brady Maniala, Bobby Mendoza, and return.
Our just new starting lineups will reveal that we've got a truly good game ahead of us. And we are underway with this important battle. I say important, not only because of the attention that the Kumaran brothers have drawn to this particular battle. It's understandable. Although I have it on good account of Fidel Mangona, that one of our sports writers, that this is actually their second meeting of the brothers, because they had met in the Father Martin's Cup, but the first time for them to meet here in the UAAP. Importante yung sinasabi mo sa pwestuhan. You said when you were coaching UP, we're already with a very good 7-7 start, but it was still not good enough because Eddie was just so good that year also.
That's right. It's important, at least I've mentioned it earlier, that to end the elimination round, at least the first round, with at least a 4-3 mark. If you have that 4-3 mark in the first round, and also in the second round, you will end up at 8-6. So it's very important for UAE to win this ball game. That itong LaSalle, they're just aiming for 5-2. If they lose this ball game, they'll still be 4-3. Kaya medyo may malaki pa rin ang chance nila rito. Ang masama talaga yung nangyari sa Adamson.
Yes.
3-4 sila ngayon. So they need at least 5 wins in the next round to make it to the top 4.
Earlier, an amazing final of fast break. A blocking foul will be whistled against, apparently, Aranya. Tomorrow will be the big final day of the first round. And, you know, tayo, we kid around. This is not to demean NU and UP, but a lot of people are saying that is the game of the season, the NU-UP battle.
Well, definitely. As much as Ateneo and FAU are both fighting for leadership, itong NU and UP naman, nobody wants to be number 8 in this league. Oh, yes. So meron din pride concern in that ball game. So a lot of interest will be generated in that ball game tomorrow.
That's starting at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and FAU goes up against Ateneo. In the second game, it's 1-2. He's in the second game, 7-8, meaning the first one. It's our smart buddy instant replay. Great hand-time shot, and the foul was whistled as well against Benitez.
Paolo Hopalde on his usual shooting form today, scoring the first 4 points for UAE. Unfortunately, he popped his bonus free throw.
Here's Yeo working with UI Pan and Benitez. Gapo is there as well. LaSalle going baseline, forced to pass off. Shot clock, 2-6. Gapo guilty of an offensive foul.
This is what we expect today's ball game. Both these teams really are good defensive teams. So great on the ball defense by Masbang, forcing it to Sigapo to turn the ball over via that charging violation.
UAE, as we mentioned, 3-3, had a two-game winning streak when they won over NU and when they won over Adamson. Then they lost to USC via that buzzer beater by Fridas. On the other hand, LaSalle has won its last two of its last three. Last time they lost was that game against Adamson. They won against USC, and that comes from behind win against UP. A shot from the outside, Hubalde has all the points. Early on now, let's go to Ana Santos for a report about UP. Ana? On the collegiate level, you do have the luxury of time. In the meantime, a foul has been whistled against Tang, his first.
That's right. Going back to what you were saying, it's interesting to note that these are the players, that majority of the players at least, were recruited by Coach Dindo Pumarin. So these are the players who will suit eventually the system that Coach Dindo wants to run for this team. And there are really two surprises in the first round. for this season in the UAAP. One for me is the dismal performance of Adamson. Everybody has been talking highly about Adamson. And the other one is the performance of UE. This one is the exact opposite. Nobody expected UE to win this many games in the first round. And now they're fighting for the number four slot at least with four wins if they overcome this victory.
Our courtside reporter for the DLSU Green Archers is Mickey Dellis, and she's ready for this report. Mickey?
Do that. They have to do a good job taking care of that basketball and limiting Casal to play the half-court set. They, by doing that, they will have a better chance of winning this ball game.
And this press was what killed UP in that comeback by the Green Archers. Look at this save by Casio from going out, but the referee says he was on the line. Cannot play sloppy basketball against LaSalle because they're quick to pounce on the loose balls and the quick opportunities to score. La Bagala, by the way, is in the ball game for the first time. He likes Olsen Rasella, and he is taking a management course at UE. Our ball game stands at 8-6 in favor of the Warriors. Here's Arellano, a regular starter for Dindo Pumaren. Oh, I failed to check. Oh, look at me. I failed to check the time piece as well. But there were only a few seconds remaining in the meantime. You know, these two guys, as we take a look at this Nescafe Ice, do the full fine assist. They've been playing together since they were probably grade 2 or grade 3.
That's right. Way back with Xavier School. And they're just continuing their dominance here in the UAAP. Of course, a great backward tandem for Coach Transumaren. But for UE, three straight turnovers for them. They were up 8-2 early on, but right now, the LSU is just chasing a two-point deficit, and Joseph Yeo was fouled while going strongly towards the basketball. That is really the strength of Joseph Yeo. Look at him.
The explosiveness towards the basket, and Maspang is guilty of his first personal foul. Our team foul count, 5 against the Green Archers, 2 against the Warriors. So KG Canaleta, very nice guy, likes to let me tell him to stop.
Big guy played back in the basket, face up, and made that fall away jumper. And look at him. He was the one responsible for that turnover. He pressured T.Y. Tang, and T.Y. Tang was forced to throw the ball to nobody. Great defense by KJ Canaleta.
You know, for the Pumaran brothers, probably, as Jasmine Payo said in the Inquirer, dinner is probably at stake in this particular battle. But there is the definitive reason also. Positions in the UAAP. We'll be back. Good size Saturday crowd as De La Salle goes up against UE. The barcadas are all around and we're here with you. Score right now is 12-8. Warriors are ahead. And take a look at our final wafer matchup for any anywhere energy grab a bar. That's a good matchup.
That's right. For the top scorer for UE, Paulo Humalde, 13 points in an average. Now it's 6 points already. While for La Salle, the second top scorer, Joseph Yeo, for just average 9.4 before the game against UB. Before the games against UB, rather, but with the 3-point explosion, made his numbers go up 11 points per ball game.
We've got Gatchalian in the ballgame for the first time for De La Salle. So, Franz Kumalin has decided to add a few more point guards because he's been thrown, a press has been thrown against him as well. In the meantime, the ball is taken away. And this is, I believe, the third time that there's been a takeaway by the Warriors. We have covered UE from day one, you and I. And we've seen how they've settled down as a team. When they played their first game against FEU, as Masbang hits that, they were in awe of FEU, as Dito would say. And in the meantime, this is the bus salvation. It's a step ahead, boy. We're just beginning to analyze and they end the play with something else right away.
That's right. The best way to break the press is that nice baseball pass, and La Salle doing wonders with that one. And JV Casio already with 4 points all on layups. But what is interesting about the game of La Salle at this point is that they're only down by 4 points and still no sight of Macardona.
Now that you mentioned it, Cardona did not start here today. There's a follow-up. You know, La Salle is being beaten to the punch of the offensive glass here. They're half a step late, and Castro is going to be called for that foul. No, they give it to Benitez, his second. So some changes being made in the lineup. Dizon is in. Benitez and Gatchalian are out. And talking of Magma Cardona, he says Tabato is also in. Tabato, of course, the son, and there he is, Santiago Tabato Jr. I did not see Santiago Cabato Sr. here yet, but he always makes sure that I see him. Bakit dito ka, boss? Hindi mo nahalo tayo. Malalaking player. Ito marami. Lagi kang nakapaligid ng malalaki. Ang bibigat ng kamay.
Oo.
Pagka, oh, thank you. Hoy, sir, kumusta ba? Boom. Not only Santiago Cabato, I used to say hi to Yoya Villamil. And boy, it's not just a hi.
Nakakasakit na minsan.
So UE has this in mind. Sige, pressing nga natin La Salle. They love doing this. Let's see if they can handle something, a dose of their own medicine.
That's a very good point. And take a look at the lineup of these two teams right now. La Salle can definitely do the same thing. But what UE has at this point is the energy and the determination, because they know if they wait for the backcourt to play defense half court, they will have a smaller chance of winning this ball game. So they're trying to do the front full court pressing off defense. Hopefully they can turn the ball, force turnovers, and yun ang nangyayari sa kanila.
Getting to know more of the players, this ball Rico Mayer Popper. And in the turnover department, La Salle has
half
nine turnovers, really only five.
To make it 10. An offensive foul will be called against Macardona. So what is obvious, at least at this point, every time the ball is knocked inside the post, always two players collapse to that guy, forcing whoever that De La Salle player is to hurriedly pass that ball. And more often than not, at least in three instances, turnover. Ten turnovers, a total of 10 points. So they've lost pretty much like 20 points already because of those turnovers.
Okay. Just to briefly take a footnote about the Pumarins, they're really just equally divided. Their mother is on the La Salle side, their father, I believe, on the UE side. So this is going to be a great dinner tonight for the Pumarin family.
Oh,
I've known them for the longest time, and Vasco. basketball is really the passion of their lives. 16 to 10 is our count. UAAP is ahead by 6. In the meantime, across the midcourt line goes Labagala. Whipping it over to Canaleta, who almost lost control. The shot clock is stripping down to 10. Labagala, good decision by the point guard. He may have missed the shot, but it was the best shot that presented itself. In the meantime, it's lost at the baseline.
Still, UE up by 6 points. LaSalle having all sorts of problems trying to break the UE style of press. And they've been successful only in like 5 times or 5 possessions. 10 points only with 3 minutes left in the first quarter.
Oh, yes, now that you mention it. Hindi nila maitawid atop the keyhole area cleanly, ano, eh? Here's Gachalian trying to break that mold they've fallen into. Kamatu on the right flank, Cardona is in the there, but he is unable to control the basketball. The shot clock is at 1, no change of possession.
So if we rewind that possession for LaSalle, it happened, they had problems trying to break that full-court defense of LaSalle, of UE, kaya na problema rin sila, inabot na sila ng 24-second shot clock violation.
And they need a timeout. We will be back with 2:41 in the quarter. You are watching the UAAP, 16-10 is a count, and there's Manu Derek right behind the UAAP bench. We all know that their mom is on the other side for France. Peace in the family.
Depende magkaingitan.
2:41, Director Al Neri on the ball. Look at the turnover story.
11 turnovers for LaSalle and only 6 for UE. And our score make it 7 for UE because of that great on-the-ball pressure defense by Gachalian.
Our graphics crew also on the ball with our turnover graphic. Samantala, the turnovers, you can expect that to happen in a game that that has a lot of the pressure defense being applied here.
Well, but for LaSalle, this is really an unfamiliar situation for them.
Okay.
We mentioned earlier that they are the best as far as taking or protecting the ball in the league. They only average like 19 turnovers per ball game. But it's very seldom that you see that they score only 12 points or 10 points and they have 12 turnovers. Very seldom you see that from a team, a disciplined team like LaSalle.
Malaganas with a good game against UST. Just score the basket on the other side. In the meantime, you know, I like the coaching staff of De La Salle. Why? It's all point guards. Jackson Jago. They've got Chi Abanilla. I know Tyrone Bautista is also there. So
Jojo Villapanto.
Yeah, Jojo Villapanto. I will not play 21 against these guys. Aha, he's on. That's Gia Bonilla. Also find De La Salle there. He was the point guard of Julie Foot, if you recall, in 1990. The quick turnaround shot. Oh, beautifully done by Casio. It's a 3.
We've seen that time and again coming off the screen. This is JV Casio connecting for his first 3-point shot. Almost a turnover again for UE. Look at all the players at least on that part of the court diving for that loose ball. Possession arrow will point to LaSalle, so LaSalle is able to save that possession. They will get the ball here on this play for them.
This was well done coming off the pick provided by Rico Meyer Hoffer of the Smart Buddy 3. It was a classic NBA live pick. Those of you who play it on the computer, the pick is done that way. It's the only game I can play. 18-13 is the count. UE has a 5-point lead. Now, those who want to beat the Sun must learn something in the way Adamson did it from game from start to finish. UE, inaposedulo. In the meantime, you cannot let the guy who has the best book, I believe, in the UAAP just get away.
Well, for Mac Cardona, he needs to enter into that scoring sheet for LaSalle. They've been down for the majority of the first quarter here, and UE somewhat having problems with their own offensive set.
They've got great basketball. off with the wrong hand. And I just say wrong because it may not be a normal shooting hand.
He had to take it with his left hand because he was trying to elude the defense of Paolo Hebalde. As a result, Paolo was guilty for that foul. Two free throws will be given to Junjun Kabato. He has yet to score into the ball game. UE still up by 3 points, but they were up by as big as 8 points earlier, 18-10, so 5-point turnaround para rito sa La Salle Green Archers.
Yes, he's a natural lefty, so he had to adjust on that last layup.
Cavado, really, if there's something that he really needs to work on, it's his consistency from the free throw line. He's shooting below 60%, and now 0 out of 2 on that trip. So a very unorthodox kind of player because he can shoot from well beyond the three-point area, but somehow hindi niya makuha yung kanyang clip from the free throw line.
There are just some things in heaven and earth that are beyond our explanation, really, sometimes. Gypsy Doom will not work, and there is a short staff that finds its way home.
When you talk about talent, definitely La Salle oozing with talent as compared to UE. But what UP has at this point is that all of them are really scrapping, all of them are really fighting for those loose balls, offensive rebounds. And look at this season, he was just rewarded because he was at the right place and at the right time after that great defensive jam by La Salle. He was there to put it back, end one situation for him. Dizon, first 2 points of the ball game, and UE up again by 5 points.
Cardona ended up with his first personal foul. Dizon stands 6-4. He's a rookie for the University of the East. 17 seconds remain in the opening quarter. Dachalian applies the brakes. Oh, here the national not closing the time. No need to panic. They have 6 seconds. That's what Franz Pomalin is telling them. Tasha hoping to go to Dachalian. It's denied. The play was well run. Natapiklet yung bola, actually. And our first quarter draws to a close. We'll try and Gregorio and your Suli Sam Sarmenta will be back with all the action for all of you on this special Saturday of Season 67. Got a friend in the audience, and kabarkada natin ang kaibigan natin yan. Okay. Dr. Matibag is in the audience this afternoon. At siya, Coach Sunny Parat,
Pagia,
who still occasionally sits on the bench, and I think most of the team, he still has the best expression of disappointment among the coaches.
That's correct.
The most graphic. 21 to 15 is our count here. So what's going to give in a game like this? Coach Ryan, both seem to be a mirror image of the other, and that's not necessarily because of the coaches.
Well, too many turnovers by both teams. Another one for UE. And the team that scores more off the turnover will have a better chance of pulling off this one. And the field goal percentage or the in the first quarter, DLSU only 9 attempts. They shot well for 67%. The reason they only shot 9 times because the number of turnovers they had in the first quarter, while for UE they had 16 attempts and made the 8. While in the free throws, we talked about the woes of La Salle from the free throw line, from Junjun Kabato to Amma Cardona. They're only 2 out of 5 from the free throw line in the first quarter. And from their own research, as a team, they only shoot 54.2% from the line. So again, that's something that Coach Fran should work on in the second half here in the UAAP. Second half of this game, and even in the second half, or the second round of this season.
There was one game, I'll tell you this, I remember from the PBA in the late 80s, Franz Pomalin, with no more time remaining, delivered 2 free throws to win the ball game for a team called Magnolia at that time. He delivered those free throws, and that's not easy to do. So that's why you have to deliver on your free throws. In the meantime, nice pass downstairs to Mayor Hoffer. That is a cool as ice assist brought to you by Nescafe Ice. Do the move, which I intend to do when I go home later. I finally saw the commercial up close. That's
the move.
Canaleta. I just like the way he's improving. And as you take a look at Francisco Madden concentrating the situation, I have just liked the way Canaleta has improved over the last 2 years.
Oh, yes, because he really didn't have the minutes that he wanted when James Yap was still there, even when Ronald Meeping was still there. So now he's really counted on by UE to really help in the scoring department. And guess what? This is the first time in his career that he's averaging his double figures here in the UE.
Okay, in the meantime, Canaleta giving up that foul. He was lost in the shuffle, so to speak. You know, this red machine is ganging up on the ball carrier, almost a triple team. Then when they were made to pay because of that lazy pass, Canaleta was suddenly lost in the mix. There's a foul by Canaleta, his first, as we mentioned.
Well, for small teams like UE, it's important that they bring the game to the backcourt of LaSalle, because every time that they're in the front court, chances are it's either an easy two-point shot because LaSalle is definitely taller than them, and the other one, that might force the big guys of Coach Tinto to foul. Dahil nga, last line on defense, wala ka na magagawa, late ka na. And fouling is always a defensive mistake, you know that. Not unless you're really forced to foul to send a player, a poor free throw player to the line. But in that situation, that will be very, very hard for UE to win if KJ Canaleta gets into foul trouble.
As we had a close-up of Dindo Pumarin earlier, I had completely missed the point that, of course, Dindo had played for De La Salle in the UAAP when La Salle already was in the UAAP and was one of the best scorers ever for the green and white. In the meantime, a foul was whistled. That will go against Tang, his second of the game. Our team foul count reveals that there have been two fouls against Stein. Now we've got Casio. I thought he was on the way out. Yes, he is on the way out. So we've got Cardona, Mayor Hopper, Capatu, Tang, and Yeo on the floor. So a bit of a smaller team on the floor, but a more productive team, I might say. Let's go to Ana Santos with this report, as Ernst Aquindel has just hit a shot. Ana?
Be wondering why guard forward Raymond Lega is not visible in the UE bench for this particular ballgame. Well, Raymond actually got operated on his right knee at around 8 a.m. this morning at a hospital in Kansas City. Due to, as some of you might recall, an injury which he acquired while playing against the Maroons last July 17. Lega was officially said to be out of the season, but Raymond's fans will be happy to know that he already had new knee and is now under the process of recovery. Raymond's rehabilitation is scheduled about a month from now.
Thank God for the technologies, the knowledge, the medicine that is available nowadays for players to recover quickly from injuries like that. I'm older than you. I recall the era of Freddie Webb and Paul Cardona. They could not recover as quickly because of the complications of knee operations at that time. Just a little simpler or a little easier, that is.
Well, before, when you suffer from an ACL tear, it's usually career ending. Ngayon, medyo career threatening lang, depende sa rehabilitation mo. So if you're really up to it, you will miss like 6 to 8 months doing intensive rehab, but you will be as good as new once you enter the court again. Ang daming ganun eh, di ba? Larry Funacher, of course, Ramil Taguba. So a lot of players are suffering from that kind of an injury here this year.
A bit of the wear and tear of a long, not only the UAAP season, but participating in other leagues as well at practice, especially in the knee area, which is the turning joint of the most abused joint of any player, especially basketball. Because not only because you turn and twist, because of the suddenness in which you turn and twist. Miguel has a report from the Green Archers bench.
Settle down is what the Archers need to do. Coach Frank asked his boys why they're panicking. He told them that they should play like the veteran players that they are. The Archers were also reminded that they do this every day. They know what to do, and they have what it takes to control and dominate this game. However, they cannot let themselves get out-hustled, and they have to stop fouling. Devin Ryan?
That's a very good report, Mickey, because, you know, you're a little more veteran team, so France is trying to tell them, hey guys, settle down.
That's right.
Settle down.
Well, give credit to UE. is for LaSalle. Even Mac Cardona, who is playing in his fifth season, is turning the ball over like crazy.
Oh, great follow-up. He's the cleanup man for UE Bison. Bison already with 5 points in the ball game. Yeo trying to control the leather, goes up. You know what's so deceptive about Joseph Yeo? You feel as if his whole body is going to fall apart as he dribbles the basketball, only to control it at the last moment and you are gone, you are burned.
Usually you make that sidestep using that footwork that you've learned through the years, but for Joseph Yeo, he can simply glide and make that step up in the air from right to left or left to right, eluding that defense, whoever that is, and as a result, instead of it becoming a charging violation, it becomes a blocking foul that a tendency mo hakabulin mo. Unfortunately, the woes again for LaSalle. This free throw.
Yes, this has been Yeo's problem. In fact, he is the second leading scorer, but he is averaging only 42% of the free throw line. Somehow you feel that his backspin is a lot different than his driving compared to his free throw.
And you know that if there's something again, so take a look at that completed steal by Joseph Yeo. Joseph Yeo likes to penetrate a lot, and chances are he will be fouled a lot. So the next thing that he should do is really work on his free throw.
That's my centers who are diba? Close to the basket.
That's right.
Good point. In the meantime, 9 points by Yeo. Oh, Tang nearly dropped to the deck, second down, missing that shot. Where will the refs point the ball to? Tell us all. 6:26 remaining in the second quarter, 28-23. Tang tips it in. Yes!
Nice shot by T.Y. Tang, and the LaSalle crowd is up right now. They're excited. They're only down by 1 point.
After being down by as large as 8, great UAAP action. This will be the trend for the entire weekend. All televised games are being carried live on the web by www.abs-cbn.com and also seen through the TFC, the Filipino channel in North America, Europe, Middle East, and other parts of the world. To our friends in the Bay Area of San Francisco, nice to have you join us for the UAAP games from the Araneta Coliseum, Sam Sarmenta for Shrine Gregorio. We also will have with us Ana Santos and Mickey Dellas. Mickey is reporting from the LaSalle bench while Ana takes care of watching the happenings on the U.S. side of the floor. So this lead has been increased somewhat. It's 28-25. It was, did they change the score?
They did change the score.
When we went for a break, it was 28-27. It's now 28-25. Okay. That sorts that out. So some breathing space for UE, but not for long, you may surmise, with the way LaSalle is playing here at the midway point of the second quarter.
Well, the cause of frustration, as far as Coach Franz Gumaran is concerned, is that the penchant of the LaSalle players to foul every time they do not get that steal. So that's always a bad habit. And as a result, they went into early foul trouble, team penalty that is, already with 5 and succeeding fouls after this penalty free throw situation for UE, and UE such a deadly team from the free throw line.
Paulo Ubalde averaging 58% from the 15-foot line. Difficult whirling shot, and Dapo finds himself on the ground, but he picks himself up and will visit the free throw line after that second personal of R.J. Mespong. Giants glide in the air, that last sequence. 5-point lead by the Warriors, 5:44 to go, second quarter. Earlier today, the USD Tigers won against Adamson, and maybe that battle for that fourth spot, although we have the entire second round to go. You know, I like the way they pose the question sometimes. If the final four were to be played today, well, people are battling, teams are battling for that fourth spot. And if it involves UE, That's why they've gone over and beyond expectations. They did not, people did not expect them to figure that prominently, but we still have the entire second round ahead of us.
So even teams like UB or NU, they still have a chance. Even if they end up like 1-6, it's a tall order by making a perfect slate in the second round, but still there's a chance.
Obaldez, three-point attempt, did not hit the target. Spin by Yeo!
That's vintage, Joseph Yeo, for you. If it's open court basketball and a lot of fun players and flares, spin move, and he could have gotten it, he could have shot it easily, but he opted for that harder shot. Kung may degree of difficulty, mas mahirap. Counts for 2 points just the same, but look at the crowd roar and appreciate that move of Joseph Yeo right after that shot.
I think there are certain players like Vital and Yeo that like to perk up the audience right on the emotional roller coaster.
What a pass by Canaleta!
Great pass using just one hand. KJ Canaleta definitely has a great vision for a man like him, and yung ball handling, pinapag-aralan yun, passing with one hand, although it's a bad habit for most of the coaches, but if you get things done, that's clear 2 points for you. Mahma Cardona guilty with that offensive foul once again. Second foul of that nature for Mahma Cardona. And a turnover once again for DLSU.
And they are down 32-29 with 4:48 to go. We are still in the first half. Sagindel working with Arellano, Canaleta, Ovalde, and Masbang. Sagindel nearly losing the basketball. Shot clock reduced to 9-3. Up and out. Canaleta up and fouled. Looks like Benitez will end up with this one.
So again, second chance opportunity for UE. We've mentioned it earlier, they're the worst rebounding team. As we take a look at that nice pinpoint assist pass by KJ Canaleta to RJ Masbang.
Full as ice assist brought to you by Nescafe Ice. Do the move. Earlier, I gave the foul to Benitez, but it is actually being charged to JV Casio. So Casio ends up with his first personal foul.
That UE is the worst rebounding team, only averaging 37 rebounds per game, but the way they're controlling the points today, I'm pretty sure that coach did the work on that in the, at least 1 week of preparation against LaSalle, because he knows that LaSalle really is a great rebounding team as well. Again, a tough shot by Joseph Yeo.
Well, it's an Olympic year, that's why the hop, step, and jump, the triple jump works, and LaSalle's press is on, they bobble that play. Casio was opting for the extra pass, but they keep possession. You've got a good one going. It's perking up. It's Huey hanging on to a two-point lead as we break for this timeout. Okay, get that UAAP fever on your cell phone with Studio 23's UAAP All Access Pass. It's your mobile ticket to the league's logos, picture messages, MMS wallpapers, live scores and news updates. Text UAAP to 2366 to get the full list of services available to Globes, Mark, Talking Text, and adding mobile subscribers. LaSalle loses control of the basketball.
Fast break points here in the second quarter. LaSalle with 6-4. Coming from Joseph Yeo and 0 for UE and field goal. 6 of 7 for LaSalle. Majority coming from high percentage shots. And for UE, they have somewhat struggled here in the second quarter, averaging only 38% from the field.
Obalde, everything except the completion, has broken away from the team. 3 minutes and 30 remaining. Here's Yeo, who's beginning to percolate. Stripped of possession. There's a foul. Good call. Maybe a tad late, but it is the right call.
That's right. First personal foul would be called against Labagala. It's just the fourth team foul for UE. LaSalle will just be no free throw shooting time already. So that means that's the fifth team foul for UE. And Joseph Yeo again will be tested from the free throw line. Only a 47% shooting from the free throw line. And he coolly sinks his first one.
He now has 14 points. beginning to hump here. He's 4 of 6 from the line.
Pinataas ko pala, I stand corrected. I said 47% from the free throw line. 42.9 pala.
Medyo
mas mababa pala.
Hindi yun ang strong suit niya. Samantala, 3:25 remaining. As Valde really getting the attention and a foul given up by Gatchalian.
Well, too much aggressiveness can sometimes be counterproductive for you. Gatchalian anticipating that pass. He was there on the anticipation. Unfortunately, he will be guilty for his second foul. So, kanina pa to, penalty situation ng Lasal. This time, Arellano will troop to the 15-foot line to shoot his two gift shots.
That's Pumaran issuing instructions to his team on the floor. He's calling on Yeo. Arellano bumps the first. We are currently tied at 33. Which is, interestingly enough, our third deadlock. That offensive foul, which gives a better perspective. In the meantime, Yeo is called for that foul as he tried to ball hawk. Well, I just envy the point guards of these two schools. You know, the two great point guards in Lindo as well as France. France has a player, I think, not the better range from three-point distance, but nobody's going to match up against Lindo in terms of speed.
That's how it's called.
I remember.
But it's called the bullet. And yes, average like 8 assists per ball game in his career.
Well, considering that he was a scorer when he was playing for De La Salle towards the turn of the 80s and 90s. Yep, that decided to fall in. 36-33.
And just mentioning to Cidito, no, just imagine the luxury of Coach Ato Badulato. There was a Tito Pumarin, a Ronnie Magzano, and Eric Altamirano, and a Jerry Esprada playing on the same team for him.
Did you tell him that Eric Altamirano was the center? And then he's having a shot to stop Kirk. The ball is loose. Basta Duvalde, gone!
Major in that one, he did not want his teammates to make that decision on the layup. Two guys were ahead of him until he opted to take that shot. 5-point lead for a UE Red Warriors, so 38-33.
Almost a 5-0 run here as we were earlier tied at 33. The shot on the wing. Gatchalian knocked that in. 2:18 to go. That was a great shot by Gatchalian, but none of the teams really dependent on the outside shot in this first half.
That's right. That was one of the few times that we've seen a perimeter shot going in for both teams.
Pick and roll does not work because the passer, first passer, took his eye off the recipient. In the meantime, an amazing pass break. Ito talaga nagmamadali sa may pass break si Ubalde kasi ayaw niyang abutan. UE by 3. Aranya's back in the ball game. He started off earlier. Has not gotten unglued here. That's a Leon. Oh, great pass inside the box.
Passing the drive and throw, that's hard to guard. Gapo finishing off with that slam dunk.
Nearly a steal. Aranya almost had a hand on that one, but it stayed away. It looks like Italian stepped on the line before grabbing him against Masbah. Sagindel is being brought back in for quarterbacking purposes. smart buddy is sa replay. Hindi siya sabi mo for trying na mahirap depensahan. Threw off the defense completely. Cheerleaders of De La Salle are already warming up on the hallway
towards the exit, and we are going to have a great halftime show, undoubtedly. In the meantime,
another miscue. As you can tell, did not have that clear position inside the court. Kaya tinawagan siya ng turnover. Almost a turnover this time. We should not expect the sound to break this press again.
Bear Hopper rejected. And they will whistle a foul.
Second one will be called against KG Canaleta, and Mayor Hoffer playing on extended minutes today, given the confidence that Coach Franz Pumaren is giving.
Energy level, because it's press all the way. As you check out this assist made by Ubalde to Canaleta, cool size assist brought to you by Nestle Ice to the loop.
Paulo Ubalde might have gotten away with an offensive foul, but going back to our point, it's a high octane game because of the way these two teams play defense. Talaga full court pressure, kaya it's also impossible to see a lot of offensive sets being executed by these two teams dahil talagang run and gun play, tremendous pressure, kaya ang daming foul dahil ang daming nag-gagamble on defense at ang daming tumataga pag nalilate na sila sa depensa.
And this is the reason why Ubalde and Yeo are playing the way they are playing right now. 40-38 as we are in the final few seconds. High energy. Players must have been on their vitamins here today. I don't think you can play at this level without your vitamins.
Importante, Mr. Pinari.
Jaco, first miss from the squad. Wait a minute, says the official.
Early
play
entry.
Violation.
That's right. So Jaco spinning his charity once again.
But I like the way LaSalle is talking to each other on the court. This is what you coaches like. Mag-usap kayo.
So yun, if there's a lull, that's an opportunity for the five players on the court to talk about the next step, whether it's a defensive step or an offensive step.
It's on the ground. Two LaSalle players grapple with it. The ball goes outside. They will whistle a foul against Sagindel.
Nakakatakot yung referee sa musugod dun sa mga players na tatawagan na mag-foul.
Exactly. It reminds me of one PBL referee. Malaki yung mata sa tatawag ng foul.
So hindi ka naaangal eh. Medyo mga intimidate ka na eh. Si Mayor Hopper will go to the free throw line once again. He split his charges earlier. Only 3.5 points per ball game and 7 minutes of action, but today talagang tuwang-tuwa ito si Coach Franz Pumaren sa performance of Mayor Hopper. In fact, because of his great performance, we've seen limited action from Benitez, and even Gavino has yet to play in today's ball game.
Now that you mention it, si Benitez hounded with 3 personal fouls also. Mayor Hopper reminds me of the Germany USA game the other day.
9% shot.
That is so revealing this series. And the game is not played anymore.
Yes.
Post up inside and bang, bang, bang. You have to shoot from the outside. In the meantime, Zagadel. Inside you go. The pass is intended for Canaleta. This is White. Oh, but Zagadel is steady at the point despite the pressure here. Into the keyhole area. Darko penetrates and a foul prior to the shot. But much ado about nothing because both teams are in penalty already.
That will be the ninth team foul for UE. And in case you're wondering why the second quarter is taking too long, it's because of the fouls. LaSalle guilty for 10 fouls, while on the other hand, as I mentioned, UE nakakasyam na foul rin. So talagang nadadragon ito second quarter na. It's turning out to be a free throw contest here in the second quarter.
Well, on that point, you know, not to scare our colleagues and friends, mga kapagkada natin sa Studio 23, Saturdays have been like this of late. Remember last Saturday, the first game every went into overtime. The other day, I think this game went into so many minutes, and that ended really late in the hour. Mga kapagkada really making sure that we deliver the entire game to you. Kompleto ang resulta.
Sulit na sulit.
Yes, exactly. 10 seconds remaining. LaSalle already in the lead. Sagadel attacks. He knows he wants to do that.
Still isn't enough time for UE. 2.2 seconds remaining on this baseline out of bounds set.
Sagadel, who strikes us as a scorer first rather than a point guard, will develop.
Problem. Mayor Hoffer. Well, I talked to Commissioner Ato Badulato about this play because I saw this in the FEU UP game where Joseph Cervantes was called for that unsportsmanlike foul.
Yes,
in the closing seconds against Denok Miranda. So apparently, FIBA rule states that every time you go, you do not go for the ball, whether you hold the arm deliberately or you hold the shirt or the waist, that is automatic unsportsmanlike foul. So two free throws will be given to PG Camilleta. He misses his first one, but with 2.2 seconds left, hindi gumalaw yung oras, they will definitely return possession. As we take a look at this slow-mo, Mayor Hoffer there against KG.
Ayon,
wala pang bola.
Without spot. Camilleta adjusting, got the second charity, and now as Coach Ryan Gregorio pointed out correctly, the rule interpretation is an execution will be possession will be retained by the Red Warriors. Everybody, I love this part of the ball game. Everybody pointing in a variety of directions. Ubalde, why not? Just short. This is close. This is tight. This is red hot. This is the UAAP. It's a 2-point lead by the Green Archers against the Red Warriors, who led by as much as 8 in the early goings. And it's time for the teams to repair to their locker rooms, and we'll prepare the stage for the cheering of these two schools, and we'll discuss this first half in just a short while.
Thank you.
have just seen the DLSU and UAAP squads with their cheer dance exhibition. Brought to you by Nestle Nonstop Forever Black, the one and only black ice cream. Stay tuned for more UAV 67, only here on Studio 23 Cover Cardamo.
In the meantime, Aranha, who did not score during his earlier stint as a starter, now gets unglued. It is a 45-41 third quarter. Glad you could be with us here this afternoon on this very special Saturday. Earlier today, the Tigers of USC won 70-65 against the Falcons of Adamson, and Canaleta gets something going. He's in double digits. Right about the conditioning, even Chris Aquino, very popular Chris Aquino, once told the LaSalle players yesterday in their game, Canaleta show, said, that was the year that they had beaten Ateneo in the finals. In the meantime, here's the pass, but Arellano has a good grip on the ball.
Well, one of the few times that UE scored on a counter attack after LaSalle scored on their end of the basketball court, but yung pace pa rin. It's a fast-paced ball game. Nahihirapan mag-shoot from the perimeter itong magkabilang kubunan and the LSU forcing UE forced again to turn the ball over. In fact, yung tinatawag sa tennis siguro ay unforced turnover. Mag-isa lang siya.
Exactly.
Walang pumwersa sa kanya mag-turnover. So, 17 turnovers already for the UE Red Warriors.
47-45, 2-point lead by teams of Taft Avenue. Aranha, Tabatsu, Yeo will attack. He has a collection of moves, but that one was anticipated. Arellano, Yeo is on top of it. Sagindel trying to make up for that error earlier. A scorer, you know he wants to score. It's like a pocket for yours, you know. Wants to go to the basket, really. There's time. 47-45 tally that he's said that on several occasions. Because we haven't scored that much, we still don't score, and a foul off the miss.
Irwin Gapo again, guilty of that loose ball foul. That will be his second personal foul, and UE attacking the basket once again.
Here's Arellano scooting to a ball to Balde. Open, yes.
He has a great stroke. You should not leave him open. And Arellano doing the right thing. Penetrating the defense and making the jump stop to make that pass possible for Paulo Obalde's 14th point in the ball game.
And backstopping him and helping him along the 10 points of Canaleta. Arellano goes baseline and manages just to squeeze through some difficult traffic there. Here's Valde, attracts the crowd. And time, whoa!
It was up against three white shirts from De La Salle, but somehow was able to score off that defense. 16 big points out of the 49 of the UE Red Warriors.
Bang! And Dindo Pomale was so right when he was coaching from the sideline. You have left tag open. He kept yelling at his players.
Well, in the first 2 years of T.Y. Tang, that's the shot that he will give him because he was never consistent from that area. And now 5 straight points for T.Y. Tang and 5 points as well for DLSU, ang kanilang kalamang.
And Vindo has seen enough to prompt him to press the timeout buzzer. It is 54-49. Green Archers beginning to sizzle. Time to meet the Barkada. Medyo halo-halo ito. Meron taga Lasal, meron din taga UE. Proving that there can be peace in the world because of Mentos. Oh, di ba? And the Barkada is made up of Jessamine, Zaire, Candice, Angela, Catherine, and Donna. All great fresh makers. Barkada here at the moment. This Barkada coming from both schools. Glad we can meet them. Here somebody three, and unless he is careful here, they foul. They foul.
Third personal for Drewin Gabo, of course. You know, si Benitez, kanina pa natin na may mention, also with three personal fouls. So,
coach on the bench.
Yes. But Drewin will stay on the basketball court. DLSU protecting a 5-point lead.
This is that moment when, you know, you coach, when you watch the tape, there are those breakthrough moments, those big moments when the mood of the game has changed. Let's go to Anna. Let's see how Dito Pumara addressed the emergency there in Anna.
Yes, Sam. And the dugout, the boys were told that it is not enough that they are playing well. They have to have the confidence that they can take on a big team such as the Sun. Coach Dito told the Warriors not to be intimidated. Instead, they should continue challenging the shot, play tough defense, and then execute. The team knows that the Sun is a tough team to take on, but they are so far doing a good job and should just stay their momentum in order to stay in the race.
Absolutely, Anna. In the meantime, a bit of the toughness ebbing in that last play. And in this play, UAAP beginning to fall apart. Tan hit a huge shot. And it is now a 57-51 encounter. This is another big heave by T.Y. Tan.
Well, second three-point shot in the third quarter. And UAAP, specifically Paolo Hobalde, becoming uncontrolled in the last three possessions for the UAAP Red Warriors. And don't look now, DLSU scoring from all positions here in the basketball court, from the outside and from layup shots.
Franz Pumarin has opted to play small, and that has given him dividends. Arellano busted loose and got a foul from Kabatu, the third of Kabatu. So the big men of De La Salle, a bit of foul trouble beginning to latch on to them. As you mentioned, Benitez with three. Gakko, how many does Gakko have?
Gakko has three as
three
well.
Three also. So you size nila, no?
For UAAP, RJ Masbang only playing 13 minutes in the first two quarters because of foul trouble as well. He has three personal fouls across his name. Marcel Arellano scoring his first free throw shot. Coach Dinda Pumari knows that his team cannot afford to turn the ball a lot of times because in the first two quarters, out of the 16 turnovers by UAAP, De La Salle was successful with 20 big points. So that's the difference in the first two quarters.
Okay.
Points of the turnover.
In the meantime, Kabatu. Tan sets up a shot. No. Canaleta takes it away. Magala slows it down. Canaleta decides to port inside the key.
Great touch. We've seen him do that time and again here in today's ballgame. KG Canaleta with 14 points, 6 coming off here in the third quarter.
He is just 2 points short of Pumaldi, who has 16. It is Yeo with 17. Tan already with 10 in the ballgame. Kabatu puts it up. It will roll out. Canaleta has a hand in it. It's off Aranya, and it will go to UE.
So UE coming back after being down by 8 points here in the same quarter. And they're playing with the confidence that they had in the first quarter. And a foul once again. And coach Franz Pumarin definitely not happy with the way his players are fouling the UE Red Warriors players.
Bang was grimacing because it is his fourth personal foul. And we've got Tang staying on to the court, and we've got Cardona in, but I speak too soon. As Basher's going to check in, the first time I covered him was about 4 or 3 years ago. Then I was in awe of his hook shot. He would just lob that shot over the outstretched arms of the Athenaeum Blue Eagles that was their very first game.
And people were like smarting, especially from La Salle. They were smarting because wala nang Don Jose.
Canaleta has 16 points and a foul against Aranya. as Rosie for De La Salle, as you pointed out. It is 59-57 with the Green Archers still in the lead. Here's that shot by Canaleta earlier. One and virtuosity.
And it helps to have like a Guido Babilonia in your coaching staff. Where Coach Dinto Pumara, and those moves were reminiscent of the back-to-the-basket moves of Guido. So talagang, before, when you look at KG Canaleta, you just expect him to just get that ball and slam dunk kung may open situation. Pero yung ganong mag-create siya for his 2 points, pihira-pihira. Pero now, at least 3 times nagawa niya in today's ball.
May content separation move, ano? Pwede na iiwanan.
Oh, may space na merong ginagawa siya para maka-extricate siya from the beach-like defense of a DLSU player.
They waste the opportunity to inch in even closer, tie the ball game. In the meantime, oh boy, excuse, now creeping on to De La Salle. Let's now check it. Mickey is ready. Mick, here's her report.
The Archers need to continue playing aggressive. They need to tighten up their defense, put pressure on the ball, and contest every pass and every shot of the Warriors. And of course, they have to stop fouling. On offense, they need to take care of the ball and continue playing together. The Archers may have found their momentum, but now it is crucial for them not to lose it. Seven, Ryan.
You were on the money there, Mickey, as you called every play exactly. That is exactly what happened on the court right now. Oh boy, but look at this. UE responding, and Sakindel at the basket. Cardona says, I want more. Bang!
And Mac Cardona is taking over. He now has 8 points across his name. And has scored the last 4 points for the LSU. UE should mark Mac Cardona because you know that when he gets up, he's simply unstoppable.
Moment. Cardona beginning to feel it. 63-59. We take a break. Okay, time now to play matchmaker here with Close Up. And let's get to meet the gentleman. It's Akira Yoshida. And the girl is Julie Tagindao from UST. The young man, is younger. That's interesting. They get to meet here. Get killer confidence to meet your match with Close Up. We're inviting you to watch games live and visit the Close Up Planet booth. And who knows, you might also be chosen as our Close Up Match Point couple. Back to this one.
JV Casio throwing the defense to him and issuing that nice pass. The 6th straight point of Mac Cardona here in the third quarter. Pero nabawi naman agad with that inside presence of RJ Osman,
who now has 6 points. You might wonder, you might say, why does he have to commit too many fouls? Well, that's the nature of his game. He has no choice. He has to play defense. He has to box out inside. Then there's nobody else. Not too many big men. Mac Cardona draws the double coverage. You're right, Ryan. They have to careful, especially Cardona keeping up. Kalina wala yung double team niya.
Wala. What a shot!
Changed his hands in the air. Pero kulang ng lakas yung kaliwa.
Medyo kinapos siya sa may air eh. Ganda ng kanyang move. Mac Cardona is now playing double by the defense of UE. UE is playing zone at this point.
And JV Casio has chipped in 10 points, valuable 10 points, for the way this ball game is going. Now Sakindel is on the court. together with Arellano as they pull out La Magala and Malagana. All great smart body three. Boom, boom, boom.
Defense was a little late there, although I saw the hand of Canaleta trying to disrupt that attempt of JV, but JV right on target. As you've mentioned, 10 points as well to tie the output of Macardon.
Whereas compared to the first half, they could not get dividends from different positions. Now they're getting them. Here's Katsalyan, who has been steady, coming off the bench. Here's Cardona, stoops down low, uses the throw. Two red corners join him, and he's guilty of traveling.
Well, Macardona is now a marked man. They will not be easy looks for him, so expect the defense to really collapse on Macardona once he handles that basketball. Forced turnover once again. Coach Franco Mara not happy with the way LaSalle executed that play, but they're still up by 7 points at 68-61.
Sometimes in your youthful enthusiasm, you just want to beat the double team. Just later on in life, as you get better and better, you know when to give up the ball when the double team clamps down on you.
Usually my pride pa yun, I will break that double team, I will split that. But if you have matured as a basketball player, you know that every time you're doubled, there's always one teammate of yours who will always be free.
I guess Lindo Pumara learned that receiving a pass from players. In the meantime, Katsalyan hits the bench. You've got Yeo back on the floor. Now Yeo is the third quarter man. I know Jojo Lastimos is the fourth quarter man. There's so many fourth quarter people, but I like Yeo in the third quarter because that's when he begins to bomb, although the quarter is down to only 12 seconds. They got dividends from Cardona. That's why Yeo was on the bench. Oh, take it away. That's a Vidal. But it's not completed. Casio, Yeo, 3-0. We're beginning to shout. It means it's going to be a great fourth quarter ahead of us. 68-61, the Green Archers stepping on the gas pedal in the third. Zoom, zoom, zooming ahead. And in control of the ball game, at least up to this point. The fourth quarter awaits all of us. Well, you know who they're cheering for. There are noisy ways, quiet ways, shy ways. Anyways, I guess you're waiting for the next line. Here's our Cinderella eye catcher of the game. She has a nice smile, Missy Valencia, St. Paul University. Very young, 17. She enjoys watching the UAAP. And you can log on to www.pinoycentral.com to vote for your favorite Cinderella eye catcher of the month. Uy, the competition are in again, huh? Okay. Okay, so what's going to give here? UE. In this quarter, the third was toe-to-toe. They led in the first quarter, but they lost some of the steam in the third.
That's right, and the second and the third, really, were the quarters of De La Salle. They're only up by 2 points. Or, yes, La Salle were up by 2 points at the end of two quarters, but now it has increased to 7 points. So UE and Saguintel, in particular, so should start scoring for them because Paolo now is a marked man, but Saguintel just turned the ball over. But Paolo Hubalde up there to save that possession. A traveling violation once again. So Wild and Julio Perry is there in the last three possessions.
Saan-saan pumunta yung bola? Oh. No, parang ping-pong yung kinoder natin bigla. 68-61 is the count. And this is how crazy that sequence was. Oh, nadulas. And Yeo was worried as to whether a foul would be called against him. In the meantime, in a season that has been laden with injuries to key players, you do not like to see more of this.
Especially as far as the University of the East is concerned, Paolo Hebalde is their leading scorer and their chief warrior, and you don't want your best guy to be on the bench because of an injury. As we take a look at that slow-mo, he might have inadvertently stepped on that foot of Joseph Yeo, so it might be an ankle sprain. Depending on the grade, you still have to put salt to put in a team position. He's clutching on his left foot at this point.
You know, when it's in slow-mo, it's even more eerie. Have you noticed? Interior, and regardless of the injury. In the meantime, Yeo was yelling at the player Hopper. The veteran was yelling at the rookie there and saying, come on, let's go. In the meantime, the Archers regain possession. Natasha does not force his way through that red wall. Yeo grinding hard downstairs there. Hopper under the basket. Was not going to get another shouting from or a yell from Yeo in that fashion earlier, but he was really berated for losing the ball.
Mayor Hopper is turning out to be the biggest surprise here in the lineup of De La Salle, scoring 8 points already, 6 in the first two quarters. And look at that, he had to take it on the other side. A nice assist pass by Joseph Yeo.
Nice to have long arms sometimes. Because it allows you to do the move, as presented to you by Nestle Bay Ice. Stops around. Arellano checks the interior. He's providing the shield, not used. Sagadell takes it outside. Arellano lobs a play, a two-batter, sorry, and it's picked up by Lasbun. Chance to recycle the offensive set. Canaleta in the rush, however, yes!
Into that. J.G. Canaleta really has that bridge in his arsenal. He now has 19 points to lead all scorers for you. And more importantly, to trim the lead of De La Salle to only 6 points.
Corner shot. That will not work for Casio. Touchback by Mayor Hopper and it'll go to UE.
This will be a big gamble on the part of Coach Dinda Pumarin. That change up on defense. We've seen Joseph Casio score on 3-point shots earlier in the third quarter because of the way they broke the zone. So ngayon, they have to look at that situation while we take a look at the 3-point shot. Top, top of the feet. Ito si KJ Canaleta. First 3-point shot in the ball game.
Dati-dati, pag gumagali si Canaleta, yun yung classic.
No! No!
Yes! Ito, okay na eh, no?
Oo eh.
70-64 is the current score, a 6-point lead by the Green Archers with 7:49 to go. Again, earlier today, if you missed our first game, 70-65 was the winning score of USD against Adamson. And Coach Ryan Gregorio put it rather succinctly when he said it could be difficult, although not yet impossible, but Adamson finds himself in a difficult situation that they must get out of quickly. In the meantime, Burns and Lindell losing control, but they retain possession.
Nice to see Paolo Hubalde back. That means it's just a minor injury that he suffered on that left ankle. But definitely will be expected to score here for you.
Sakindel says, let's be systematic about this whole situation. Although the shot clock is now winding down to 9. No pass picked up by Palaganas. The shot clock is not infringed.
Gendel has not done a good job here for UE. He has not joined in the fray as far as scoring is concerned. He has not done a good job distributing that leather to his open teammates. And worse, he has like 3 assists, three turnovers rather in the fourth quarter.
Our time remaining is 7:19. The Green Archers in control of the ball game. He just joined us earlier. UE even led by as much as 8 when it was 18-10. Air Hoffer finds an angle. Just missed out. Benitez, those long arms keeping them in good stead, but Yeo guilty of the travel. It means then you start to step on your hand and shoulder kick, forces you to end up confused, which is your pivot foot actually.
And just a tiny bubble on that pivot foot will result in a traveling violation. And si Joseph Yeo, dahil quick na yung kanyang feet, parating natatawagan na foul. Nagyan ang turnover.
Valde grinding hard, shoots on the way down. No, sir. It's been thrown by Benitez. Benitez already with 6 rebounds in the game. Yeo dishes off. Cardona. No, not quite. Valde looks ahead, flips it over to Sagitel. Motor, no. Valde creating possession. Misses. Follow up Palaganas. No. Here's Cardona pushing it hard. Cardona down.
On the way for his runner, he was up against the defense of KJ Canaleta and Macma Cardona, 8 points all in the second half.
And the green and white beginning to roar. And we will segue into a timeout. Stay glued and enjoy your Nescafe 3-in-1. Masarap sa break time.
They suddenly switched on Hubaldo being the point guard. They could not get anything from Labagala and Sagindel. So they might as well get Paolo to play the point, as you mentioned. Third foul on Yeo.
But you give up something when you put Hubaldo as the point guard, because obviously he will be looking at the direction wherein he will be forced to pass first. And he is like the best shooter in that team. So now, ang maganda naman dito, yung bantay na ididikit sa kanya, so that might leave KG Canaleta open for shots like this. Umawa yung tira ni KG's 21st point here, and just a brilliant performance for KG Canaleta, not just today but in the last three games of UE.
Wala pang dunk yan, ha? Tama. As we enjoy our Nescafe 3-in-1 during this timeout requested by De La Salle. Samantha here with Coach Ryan Gregorio as we check that shot early. It is the sabi po. He is now able to create that separation. I know Guidao Babilonia didn't have that much of a range, but I'm sure he has helped with the footwork.
But the important thing is that he can start up with his back to the basket and then do series of moves like an inside pivot just to face the basket and score on that dribble step back.
Look at this. This is living up to its marquee billing, 17 for Yeo, 16 for Paolo Hubaldo and Milo Wafer. For anytime, anywhere, energy, grab a bar now.
It's just a matter of time for Joseph Yeo to make some room again. Remember that, like, 15 points out of the 17 all scored in the first two quarters, but still nothing here in the fourth quarter for Joseph Yeo.
Oh, another miscue. Now, Aurelio Cardona was already going to the basket. That is a tendency many of us who have played this game tend to do. You're already thinking of your shot without having the ball.
And most of the time, that's a turnover.
Papunta na siya sa basket eh. Ang kanya, bibilipi siya. Oh, great pass inside, although Cardona is nailed by the D downstairs. He passed to Valde. A bomb passing Benitez. Nobody has it. There, Hopper has it to Yeo. Timed at the 3 and 20. This is pulsating basketball as Cardona tries to establish some kind of organization together with Casio and Yeo. But Cardona suddenly is in a rush.
Somehow, he has that ability to sneak his way in, look for that tiny opening for his unorthodox plays. 12 points, making 14 points. For Mahma Cardona, I've mentioned it times again, 10 out of the 14 coming in the third and the fourth quarter.
Mama 10 sa kanan, dadaan ang sa kaliwa. Oh, yes, what a day for JG. And he says, okay, I should keep quiet. But he is hot. How can you not say anything?
Well, that's an in-your-face attack, maybe Pharaoh Hopper will know it. The third time, KG Canaleta does it again, that he has to stay close and play phone booth defense, otherwise KG will just shoot it every single time.
Yeo pops. Oh, Alawit rebound. It's been a long time since I've seen a Alawit rebound. Last time I think it was when Nelson Asaidono would do it. There's a foul on Bear Hopper in fourth. Bear Hopper with a good game. He has to sit down because of four personals. Anyway, UE cannot just trade baskets here. They have to make some stops. There's a foul. Because the distance is 5 points and the possessions are now limited with just 2 minutes and more remaining.
That's right. Two possession ball game for DLSU. Great attack by Paolo Obaldo. This is what I'm saying, because Paolo can definitely score. He can be a target by the defensive system of De La Salle. That is a lot of help, a lot of defensive sacrifice on the penetration of Paolo Obaldo. And if you are late, Paolo Obaldo is going by you and score off that layup. But Paolo, really great guy that he is, as we take a look at the think tank of DLSU earlier, now Coach Dito Kumarin, happy with the performance of Paolo Obaldo. Because Paolo's difference is, he has great vision as a guard, he can be a two guard, and he can be a point guard. Now, he has created a lot of semblance of teamwork here, especially in offense for UE, and don't look now, DLSU only up by 3 points.
As we enter the final 2 minutes, what has been a great Saturday in basketball here on Studio 23. Cardona. Trying to yank it away. Yeo downstairs. Heavy traffic. There's a foul downstairs.
Foul will be called against Malaganas, his second personal foul. And I saw referee P5 Buenaventura signal that it was not on the act of shooting. It happened down low, so just an out-of-bounds play, a baseline to be specific. Look at P.Y.
Yun ang una niyang senyas eh.
Yes.
Yun ang una niyang senyas. Bang is on the bench. Earlier had a collection of 10 points. But Cardona has been prolific of late. Casio, lots of threes. Strikes away. And here's an opportunity for UE to knock on the door. Obaldo. Moving to the point position, 15 on the shot clock. Canaleta, top of the key, on top of 16.
Boom!
Yes!
He can feel it! And again, Paolo Obaldo, his ability to spot an open teammate and to spot not just a teammate, but the hot teammate in KG Canaleta. And Joe throwing the ball away, and La Salle really in shambles at this point.
They need time on the floor for some control. That's why he's being dispatched right now. However, UE with a chance to regain the lead. They led in this ballgame, in case he just tuned in. They want to go quickly, and Canaleta has it. Masbang can give it to them. Yes! time down to a minute and 3 seconds. Pull out your Nescafe 3-in-1. Enjoy this timeout. This is not yet over. UE by one.
Giving off that unselfish pass to KG, while KG giving off that nice perimeter jumper for RJ Masbang, who was definitely wide open. UAE down by 5 points earlier, 77-78. Now up by 1 point. So a 6-0 blast in the last 2 minutes for the Red Warriors.
In the meantime, off Yeo's drive to the basket, a fourth personal foul has been whistled against Masbang. You know, he will not allow people just to drive inside their shaded area.
Fourth personal foul though for RJ Masbang, but no easy picking for Joseph Yeo on that layup shot. We've expected that. Joseph Yeo again, only 2 points in the third and the fourth quarters for DLSU University. His free throw will be tested once again, and he misses the first one. Only a 42% free throw shooter in the season, and the DLSU boys are really, really unhappy with the turn of events.
Second free throw. Another miss. And the rebound is controlled by Canaleta with 48 seconds remaining. Both sides will have to play smart basketball here. Their respective causes, the double team on Ubalde. He embraces it, it's a jump. Where does the possession arrow point? It's De La Salle's ball.
Paolo Ubalde with a crucial turnover. He kept on dribbling, and on the blind side, T.Y. Tang was there to offer help. Look at that, off the spin, T.Y. Tang was there to force that turnover, and La Salle will have another chance to equalize or grab the upper hand again.
UAE may think of using some fouls. You know, Boya Villena, our scorer, quickly pointed that out to me, because now they have 14 fouls, 78-77. Now, LaSalle needs a clean look at the basket to be able to regain the lead here. They don't have to rush it.
And they don't have a timeout left, so the maturity of LaSalle being tested here in the last 20 seconds. A back to the charge will be called against Joseph Yeo. So a turnover once again. And for Coach Jeter Pumaren, timeout left.
Yeo, ayuno, kinamaan. Is this going to be a king-size upset by Dito Pumaren and his gritty UE Red Warriors? And a foul given up. A solid penalty.
Well, it has been a 12-2 run here for the Red Warriors since the 4 minute and 45 mark here in the fourth and final quarter. And again, I've mentioned it earlier, in the last 1 minute and 40 seconds here in this fourth quarter as well, DLSU was well on top, 77-72, but now Paolo Ubalde will be tested. His chance for the acid test. He has 18 points already. If you take a look at the difference here in the fourth quarter for Dito, good things started to happen when he put Paolo Ubalde at the point guard. Semblance of offense happened there. A great assist pass here and there, and now he made the first free throw. A chance for him to increase his lead of UE, give a little pressure for LaSalle, and now it becomes a 3-point lead for them.
It is now 80-77. Here we go. Tang trying to look at the field. Yeo has it. Yeo can nail a three. Tang dishing off to Casio. Three with five. Wide. They need this. Underneath, of course, at close range. 6 seconds remaining.
Baseball pitch to Masbang. Masbang will take it casually and score.
LaSalle has no time on them.
They rush it. Yo! No! And look at this. UE has won against De La Salle. 82-79. And the possibility, no matter how remote, of a shot at the final four slot presents itself to UE.
That's correct. 4-3 winless.